What's up, everybody? We are live. Welcome again to another installment of Music Review, and we will be reviewing The Message by Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five. All right, so for Melle Mel, we're gonna get into his verse. A child is born with no state of mind, blind to the ways of mankind. A child is born every day, and a child is innocent. A child has essentially, a child should have no fears, you know what I'm saying? He doesn't know what's ahead of him in this life that he's going to live in. So he's blinded by that fact of like, yo, he doesn't know how humans gonna act. He don't know how tough this world is going to be to him. He doesn't know about any of that. God is smiling, but he's frowning too, because only God knows what you're gonna go through. The places you play and where you stay looks like one great big alleyway.
You'll admire all the number book takers, thugs, pimps, and pushers, and the big money makers, driving big cars, spending 20s and 10s, and you wanna grow up to be just like them.
Smugglers, scramblers, burglars, gamblers, pickpocket paddlers, and even panhandlers. You say, I'm cool, I'm no fool, but then you wind up dropping out of high school. Alright, so basically in his area, he's going to admire and look up to the negative things. So he's born in negative areas, and he's going to, of course, that's going to be his world, his life. He doesn't know anything outside of that. So he sees the people that he thinks is cool, like the people that's getting money, the people that's doing crime and stuff like that. It's very sad to say, you know what I'm saying, that people actually glorify those type of people and grow to be just like that. Your place of privilege gives you the opportunity to branch out into different things. You don't have to worry about seeing drug dealers in your neighborhood or bad influences, you know what I'm saying? But people that live in worse environments than you, that's what they see. That's what they see around them. And of course, they're gonna gravitate towards that probably 7, 8, or 9 times out of 10, you know what I'm saying? So you like, that's why it's hard to say sometimes, because like, you could say, yo, why do people join gangs? Why do people end up doing bad things? But you gotta understand the way they grew up in, you know what I'm saying? Yes, you should have a mind to think for yourself, but then again, people are easily influenced, you can't lie about that. Or people just think that this, just like niggas living in America think that America is the only country in this world, or the things you see in America is how the whole world functions. That's not true. When you branch out, you see different things, and it changes up your mind. So when you're staying in their own hood, in their own bad circumstances, of course that's gonna, you know, affect them and get into your mind thinking, oh, this is the only way how people live. So of course they're gonna succumb to those things. So that's why it's like that for them. So when he says, you say, I'm cool, I'm no fool, but then you wind up dropping out of high school. He's saying that, yo, you say that you're not stupid, you're cool, you're this and that, but then you wind up letting that life consume you, then you dropping out of something that can potentially better your life, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, you are the fool in actuality. You're not cool for doing what you're doing, you know what I'm saying? The positive situation that you're not seeing is positive, you're putting that aside to do something that could, you know, put yourself into compromised positions like jail or death. Yeah, man, that's a good line, and that's why I like the whole verse. And you're a Maytag, spent the next 2 years as an undercover fad. Now, you know, see, I don't know, because painted in media and all like that, and TV shows and movies, when niggas go to jail and shit, they be raping you, you know what I'm saying? So listen, I don't know about that, but that's what I see in TV and movies. So that's why I think, like, when you go to jail, you're gonna have a surprise visit from the booty warrior, and you don't want him, because you know, if you know, you know.
Now I tell you what, I like you and I want you. Now we can do this the easy way, or we can do it the hard way. The choice is yours.
Being used and abused to serve like hell, till one day you was found hung dead in the cell. It was plain to see that your life was lost. You was cold and your body swung back and forth. But now your eyes sing the sad, sad song of how you lived so fast and died so young.
So don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head.
It's like a jungle sometimes. It makes me wonder how I keep him going under. When he's talking about you just now in jail, now you turn to, you know, an undercover gay person, you know what I'm saying, because you got your manhood taken. You're being somebody's, you know, essentially somebody's bitch in jail, you know what I'm saying? And now you know, you're scarred, you're traumatized from that, and now you're fucked up in the head, and now you're found dead, hung in your cell. So when he says you're gonna live the sad, sad song of how you live life so fast, but you die so young, basically you live your life very fast, doing a fast life, selling drugs, doing this and that, you know what I'm saying? But now you die so young. You did everything you in your life, and you realize that, yo, that shit was just bullshit what I did, and I just threw away my whole life. And now it's too late to realize that, it's too late to change your life because you're 6 feet under, you know what I'm saying? If you like the song, tell me what verse you liked. Tell me why you liked Melle Mel's verse as much as I did in the comment section below. More like, what does that verse mean to you? You know what I'm saying? So I hope you like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.